Today's video, we're taking a look at 5 entry-level cooling fans for a total of $55, or 5 premium cooling fans for a total of $150. Is the $95 price difference worth it? Did I make a mistake spending the extra money? I'm going to compare a combination of the stock case fan and entry-level Cooler Master fans versus the premium Noctua fans. Stay tuned as we do the comparison. As you're watching the video and you find it helpful, please consider liking the video and subscribing to the channel for future content. Now let's get to it. Welcome to another episode of the Wong Reviewer. I recently built a custom desktop computer for 4K editing, taking some parts from my old setup along with purchasing some new parts. The case is a Corsair Series 275R mid-tower, an ASUS Prime X570 Pro motherboard, a GTX 1070 video card that I took from my own machine. There are 5 fans in total, 2 stock Corsair fans, and 3 additional Cooler Master entry fans. One of the things I noticed when I turned it on was how loud the fan was. The fan speed and pitch was very unbearable. Even with the office door closed, my family was telling me they can still hear my computer. Here are the readings using a decibel app on my iPhone. I'm not sure how accurate it is, but should be good enough to establish baselines and hopefully see a difference. The reading, not turned on, ambient noise, the reading with the cover on, and the reading with the cover off. After some research, I came across the brand called Noctua. They are the premium fans that will reduce the amount of noise and it's supposed to be more efficient. So this is what it looks like. I bought 5 of these, 120 millimeter size. The model is NF-S12A PWM. Even says premium fan on there. So let's install them and see if it makes a difference. Here's the reading for ambient noise. Right now I'm using this app called Decibel X on the iPhone. If I'm quiet and the ambient noise is around 25, 26. When I start talking, obviously it goes up, but 25, 26. Okay, so let's power it on and see how loud it is. Around 41, 42 without me talking. I'm gonna take the cover off now. If I place it in here. So you can see the reading's about in the 50s. All right. So what I'm gonna do is I'm going to switch out the fans. There are 5 fans in total. There is one right here, it's 120 millimeters, 2 on the top, and then 2 right in the front here. So I'm gonna place all of them and see if that makes a big difference for us. I've taken out one of the coolers and now I'm just installing the new Noctua fan. It's brown and beige in color as I line it up. So it does provide you with these rubber screws that you can attach to the case. As you can see here, it's pretty tiny. And I was trying to string it through the holes. And this was actually a very difficult process. And as you can see in the video, I've tried and tried, even using a pair of pliers to pull it through, and eventually I just actually gave up and just used the provided screws. Just a quick update, I have installed 4 of the fans already. I've installed the 2 front ones, the 2 top ones. The only one I'm missing right now is replacing the back one. But before I do that, so my experience so far has been pretty painless in terms of setting it up. I did not use these rubber mounts. It was very difficult. I gave up after 15 minutes. But as you can see, it's stretchy. And I actually, using pliers, snapped one. So what I did was I just used the provided screws that they provided for you. So it's kind of hooked up now. And what I'm gonna do is I just wanna quickly share with you and unbox what comes with the fan. Right off the bat, this is actually a pretty box. You know, it says it won an award-winning design, anti-stall knob, AO frame, stepped into design, inner structure, microstructure, custom design PWC IC with SED, low noise adapter, extensive cabling options, and SSO bearing. All sounds really fancy. I'm not sure what stepped Intel design means or inner surface microstructure, but I'm sure you can look that up. The only thing I was really wanting was to have quiet, efficient fans. Here, when you open up, there's the fan here. This is a really nice box. Gives you the different mounts. There's different cabling options as well. There's an extension cable. There's a Y cable, so if you have two of them, which I've used. A low adapter, which limits the amount of RPM using the cable, as well as the four screws. And then here's the design. I guess it does talk about the airflow and the design of this as well. Okay. We unbox it. Here's the fan itself. And here's all the different cables. All right. One thing you notice about the cables is they are lined with some kind of sheet. And then it's also labeled for you and tells you what it is. So for instance, this one, extension cable, Y cable, the low noise adapter. Again, this is really well thought out, well done. Again, you are paying a premium price for this. So in terms of price, this fan runs $30 Canadian. And this Cooler Master one, which I originally bought and installed, was $11 Canadian. So I'm really hoping that I didn't make a huge mistake here by switching out. Hopefully that the price difference is, you know, does reduce the decibels and makes it a little bit more quieter. Okay, now let's install the last fan. Oh, this is the stock Corsair fan that was on the one in the back and one in the front. So this is the one in the front. Made in China. Brushless fan. All right, so that's the stock one. Now note, these screws are different. They have that notch at the end to expand, to kind of grip on. Alright, so last one, that's installed. So let's turn it on and hopefully it makes a big difference. So my initial thoughts after installation, it was very easy to install, just like any other cooler fan. I do like the fact that they have this rubber, these rubber corners here to kind of dampen the vibration against the case, which is nice. Hopefully that makes a difference. The cabling is nice. I cleaned it up as much as I can. The only thing I don't like about the fans is the color. It's a two-tone brown beige sort of look. I guess it makes it look premium, almost like leather-like, versus the Cooler Master straight up black. So I was kind of hoping for a stealthy computer. I actually took off all the RGB lighting. I wanted a black. The only thing I can't change is the AMD. I probably can unplug it, but now you can kind of notice, especially when you have a tempered glass and you look through it, this really stands out. For me, that's a cosmetic annoyance. It would be under my desktop, under my table anyway, so I won't really see it, but if I had it mounted on my desk, I think it would bug me. So before I turn it on, I'm going to measure the ambient noise again, and then we'll take a look at the readings. So let's take a look at the ambient noise. Okay, it's fluctuating between 25 and 26. So it's having around 47 decibels. I think that reduced it by about 3 or 4 decibels, but already I can tell the pitch is less noticeable, which is great. It does sound a little bit stealthier and quieter. I've been using the new setup for a week now. So is it worth an extra $100 to upgrade to a premium fans to reduce the decibel from 51 to 47 decibels, which is only a difference of 4 decibels? That works out to about $25 per decibel for a reduction. From a value proposition, that is pretty expensive and doesn't make sense to upgrade. From a subjective point of view, the noise and pitch reduction does make a big enough difference for me that I'm just going to absorb the cost, even though it doesn't financially make sense. If you found this video helpful, please like the video and subscribe to the channel for future content. Thanks again for watching, and until next time.